Well, for the goalkeeper coach, we have to adapt with the times. Football has changed. The goalkeeper's role has changed. So the goalkeeper coach's role has to also change. Now he needs to have a real understanding, not just of the role of the goalkeeper, but the role of the team as such, and how the goalkeeper fits in with this team. That's the first thing. He needs to understand everything about football. The second thing is then he needs to work in an environment where there is so many coaches. It's not just the head coach and assistant coach and the goalkeeper. Now you have fitness coach, you have psychologists, you have sports scientists, you have physios, you have a big, big staff. So he has to fit in this staff also and know how to do that. He also has to do it on the pitch, because if we're going to develop the goalkeeper in the modern way, it's not just about developing his skills as a goalkeeper. He has to now develop his skills as a player within the team. So that means then that the goalkeeper coach needs to work also with other staff, work with outfield players and goalkeepers to develop the performance of the goalkeeper in the game. You have knowledge and you have understanding of the game if you have played at a good level, but maybe not the skills of a coach. You have to develop the skills also, because playing and coaching is two different things. And then you have to have the confidence and the attitude. This course here is more about the coach educators. And for me, the most important thing is the coach educator who understands goalkeeping, the philosophy of education, and then being able to drag it out of the coaches to help the players and the goalkeepers on the pitch. Listen, the goalkeeper is the most important player on the pitch. Maybe the striker is important also, maybe the midfielder, but the goalkeeper has a big, big role in the team. No longer is he just the one who catches the ball or makes the save. That's very, very important, most important part. But he also now has to play with his feet, and he is part of the team when we're playing offensive play. So I think it can be very, very satisfying for a young player to have this role, because he is a big member of the team, and he can develop and become a star now. And he can earn lots of money being a goalkeeper also, not like my day. I remember everything. The game itself, it was a very warm day in Genoa. And of course, you had a good team, a very good team. Your star player was Hadji, and he was very dangerous in the game. And then of course it came to the penalty shootout. And for me, it was a big moment. I remember the moment when Daniel Tomofti walked up from the halfway line to take his penalty. I had gone the right way for each penalty, which was unique and interesting, because in the cup final back in Scotland the month before, I only went the right way for 1 out of 9 penalties. So it was a big change in the World Cup. So at this point, when Daniel Tomofti walked up, he was a sub. He came on as a substitution, and he didn't look overconfident, I must say, when he walked up. Then he stood at a very acute angle on the right side to the ball. So I kind of knew that he was going to put it to my right side. And then when he struck it, it was a nice height, and it was an easy save. But it was a big moment for us in our life, because, of course, Dave O'Leary then scored the winner. I remember the goalkeeper, Lung, his son is on the course here also. It was great memories. It had changed my life and changed the perception back in Ireland. I look for his confidence, composure. I look for his ability to make the big saves at the right moment in the game. I also then look to see how he influences the game when he has the ball with his feet. Of course, his technique, but also his decision-making is crucial. I think the profile of the goalkeeper has also changed now. He is more taller, slimmer. He is quicker, better movement. Our day was more about power and strength. Now it's about being like a player, but also have an ability to make the big save. So that's what I look for. The best goalkeepers at the moment probably is De Gea. Buffon, of course, is still playing, but he was my hero because he changed and he adapted. When he was a younger goalkeeper, he didn't have to work too much with his feet. But then he adapted and changed and became also like a coach on the pitch.
I came here 2 or 3 years ago the first time. I think they didn't really know what to do, but with the information we give from UEFA, with the help we try to bring, they start to be structured. They start to make a plan. They know what coaching is, what tutoring is. So I think that in a short lapse of time, in 3 years, they progress enormously.
Da, mă bucur foarte mult pentru acest eveniment și că UEFA acordă o așa mare atenție special rolului portarului și pregătirii portarului, deci perfecționarea antrenorilor de portari chiar era necesară și încă o dată să iese în evidență cât de important este antrenorul în staff. Deci antrenorul de portare are și el un rol foarte important în stafful tehnic al unei echipe. Portarul fiind unul dintre cei mai importanți jucători din cadrul unei echipe, necesită o pregătire specială acum, analiză, și atunci și antrenorul de portar trebuie să evolueze în pregătirea lui.